Baby, ya yo me enteré. Se nota cuando me ve. Ahí donde no has llegado, sabes que yo te llevaré. Y dime qué quieres beber. Es que tú eres mi bebé. Y de nosotros, ¿quién va a hablar si no nos dejamos ver?
Welcome back to the channel. It's been a while, that's for sure. I mean, it's been like 3 months since I posted my last YouTube video. Honestly, I wanted to post, but like, it was a lot to balance with school and this, and then I had baseball starting too, so, you know, but now school's winding down and I got a lot more free time on my hands, so I decided, you know, I'm going to start baseball, and what better way to start than talking about baseball's problems? This isn't going to be about the unwritten rules. That's a whole different video I could talk about. I could make a very long video on that. That's something that 100% needs to be changed, but I'm not really going to talk about that in this video. This video is about something completely different. I mean, like it or not, baseball is just a completely different game than it was 50 years ago. It's different than it was in the 1990s or the early 2000s. It's even different than it was just 5 years ago. All you have to do is go back 8 years to 2013 to find the last time the league strikeout rate was under 20%. Just 6 years ago in 2015, which is coincidentally the same year the new juiced baseballs were introduced after the All-Star break, is the last time league ERA was under 4. And in 2019 and 2020, league ERA was at a collective 4.49, which is the highest it has been since 2006 when it was 4.53. Still, there is a noticeable difference in these eras. Although walk rate has pretty much remained steady, usually hovering around 8 to 9% for a very long time, there are two very noticeable differences: home runs and strikeouts. The single season home run record was broken twice in the past like 4 years, once in 2017 and then again 2 years later in 2019. Over 6,000 home runs were hit in each of these seasons, and that was never even come close to in the height of the steroid era. The pandemic-shortened season of 2020, which was just 60 games, there were still over 2,000 home runs hit. It was a pace for well over 6,000 home runs. This really had become known as the three true outcome era. MLB decided that they wanted to lower run scoring, or more specifically, lower home runs and increase balls in play. Hopefully, it would encourage players to strike out less, walk less, since the home run threat was not as big. In short term, what they did is make the balls have more drag, which causes them to fly shorter. The result was a decrease in ERA by almost half a run, the lowest league batting average, as I record this, of all time at 236. Yes, the league is hitting 236, which is the lowest of all time, and I know batting average, it's a terrible stat, but it still shows like kind of what the effect of these new baseballs have done. And of course, pitchers are better than ever before, and I'm going to get into that later, but that is just part of it. And it's crazy that as soon as they changed the baseballs, well, we got 6 no-hitters this year. I mean, league average BABIP is the lowest since 1992, which does make sense. Because, I mean, think of it like this.
Here, let me explain it like this. Let's say the pitcher is throwing a baseball, and he throws 2 pitches. Both are the exact same pitch, both are 95 miles per hour, both are right down the middle, and the batter swings at both pitches and hits them the exact same distance. I know this is unlikely, but just bear with me here for a second. The first pitch, it was with a real baseball. This ball goes 350 feet to left field. The next pitch, it was with the T-ball. The T-ball, which is obviously less powerful than a real baseball, it goes just 300 feet because T-ball doesn't have as much pop.
Now, obviously this is a bit exaggerated, but this is the effect that a dead end baseball is going to have in a game, which makes it easier for defenses to turn batted balls into outs, hence the low BABIP, batting average, on-base percentage. Everything is just incredibly low. I would have to travel back to 1972 to find the last time the league on-base percentage has been lower. It was at .311 that year, and as I record this video, it's at .312 this year. And as for home run rate, it's down by just about 0.4%, which is not huge, but it's still significant. It's still a decrease from home run rate last year. But now, you might ask, did it have the desired effect of more balls in play? Nope.
I mean, just look at this chart. 2021 is the highest three true outcome rate of all time. And every year since 2015, it has increased. And coincidentally, 2015, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, and 21 are the seven highest seasons by three true outcome rate of all time. 17 of the top 20 seasons in three true outcome rate are in the 2000s. Now, this is what people's problem is. They don't like that there are so little balls in play. And I can understand that. People like seeing web gems.
Towards the middle, Fletcher backhand to Simmons. What a play for a double play.
They like seeing, you know, singles and doubles or hustle plays and stuff. Personally, I really don't mind the three true outcomes. I'm still welcome to it if I'm being honest. But for arguments and video's sake, I'm going to make an argument for both sides, go over pros and cons, and propose some possible solutions. Why would people want it to stay? Well, some people may like the outcomes. I mean, who doesn't love like a huge breaking ball that just completely fools the hitter and makes him look stupid?
The 11th.
Or a fastball that's blown right past him.
Comes a 1-2. Got him!
Strikeouts like that are pretty awesome, I gotta say. It also, it does speak to pitchers being better than ever. Plus, I don't think any changes would affect walk rate much. It has been between 7 and 10% every year since 1950, and more recently it's been even closer to 8 and 9% than ever. And as for home runs, I mean, huge moonshots are very exciting.
So this is a kind of crazy fact that I found out while recording this video, but Nomar Mazara has the longest hit home run of the StatCast era at 505 feet. Not Giancarlo Stanton, not Aaron Judge, not Bryce Harper. Nomar Mazara.
I love home runs. They're cool. They're amazing. I don't think the number of home runs hit makes them boring or repetitive or whatever. I think they're really awesome, and it's the way the game is heading, and I really have no complaints about that. On the flip side, people will argue that it decreases the number of possible web gems, which is true. That being said, balls are still being put in play almost 65% of the time, although that number is diminishing. Three true outcome rate has jumped up 6% since 2015, which if it continues like that, you know, balls in play are going to be even more and more rare. All that being said, whether you think MLB is trying to fix the right problems or not, deadening the baseballs was not the right approach. It didn't work at all. It decreased run scoring, yes, but didn't decrease the three true outcomes. It didn't decrease strikeouts or walks, and home runs only decreased by a little bit. I mean, part of this is that the game is changing, and FOs are taking all new approaches. Promoting home runs, launch angle, instead of, you know, just singles, batting average, and now they're leaning towards more getting on base and hitting for power. Hitting the ball harder, too, because, I mean, if you hit the ball hard with great launch angle, you are more than likely going to have better results, which is going to lead to more runs, which is going to lead to more wins, which is what every organization in baseball is trying to do, except for, you know, the ones who are rebuilding. But in the long run, they're trying to win. So baseball is just not going to go back to more balls in play and move away from the three true outcomes, because that's not what FOs necessarily want to do. Add in the increasing number of shifted plays, it doesn't help either. In 2015, when StatCast first started tracking the shift, just 9.6% of pitches were being shifted. Fast forward to 2021, this year, 32.7% of pitches have been shifted. We went up from under 10% to almost a third of the time a pitch is being shifted on. That is an incredible, incredible increase. And it's not a coincidence that strikeout and home run rate have gone up in that span with batted balls going down. Beating the shift is not easy as people would like to make you think it is. The shift is very effective at limiting base hits. Home run rate with an infield shift on is at 4.2% since 2015. Strikeout rate is 22.9%. On a standard infield alignment, home run rate falls just short of 3%, while strikeout rate is at 21.7%. Not only that, but walk rate also goes up more than 2.5% from 7.5 to 10.1% to be exact with the shift on. That is a true three outcome rate of over 37% when the shift is on since 2015, and just above 32% with the shift off. I mean, essentially, the shift quite clearly promotes the three true outcomes. Hitters know that hitting into the shift is an out, and the best way to beat that is going to be a walk, or it's going to be a home run. And, you know, you're going to sacrifice those base hits for strikeouts because that's just the way the league is moving. That's just the direction baseball is going. The league BABIP with the shift on is .281, and without it, it's .301. That's significant, and hitters know this. teams know this too, which is why they're shifting. So they develop more home run or bust approaches overall. However, I think banning the shift would be complicated, and I don't necessarily love the idea of banning the shift. It adds in so much strategy. Maybe you can suppress it, but I don't think you can ban it. Like, maybe you gotta say, all right, at least one infielder has to be in the dirt. Or you can't, I don't know. I don't know exactly how they would suppress it, but I just don't think banning it would be great.
And I really don't think suppressing the shift would, like, change that mindset, because if you see guys shifted, you're still more likely to develop a home run or bust approach.
I mean, the teams who do shift have such a huge competitive advantage. Shifting has become such a huge part of baseball. Other solutions include doing something with the mound. For example, in 1968, when league ERA was the lowest it has ever been since the dead ball era, Bob Gibson had a 1.12 ERA, and then they proceeded to lower the mound. The results were immediate, an increase from a 2.98 league ERA to a 3.61 league ERA. As we start to enter another pitcher-dominated era, so to speak, could this be the right solution? It's honestly probably my favorite one, if I'm being honest. It would hypothetically make pitchers less dominant, allow batters to be more disciplined, and put more balls in play, because a ball would be thrown on a flatter plane rather than being thrown more down on a downward plane.
Think of it like this. If the mound is at 10 inches, which is where it's at right now, a baseball is thrown on more of a downward plane to get to home plate. This creates the illusion of more rise, so to speak. It also makes the batter have to have more of an upward swing, which is a little bit more difficult than a flatter swing. Lowering the mound to 8 inches would cause the ball to have less rise and be on a flatter plane. This would make it easier for batters to see the ball, easier for them to hit. It would make pitchers less dominant. It would probably increase the number of balls in play, decrease home runs, probably decrease strikeouts as well. Overall, just have the effect that Major League Baseball is actually looking for.
Additionally, people have suggested moving the mound back, and honestly, I think this is a really bad idea. Not because of the traditional 6 feet 6 inches thing, no. I mean, I'm not a baseball traditionalist. I get why people would say no, 6 feet 6 inches. I mean, it's married to the sport. It's iconic. That's not why. I think it could have the opposite effect desired. But first, let's get into some other things. Average four-seam fastball velocity has increased from 91.9 in 2008 when pitch tracking first started to 93.6 miles per hour this season. Even curveballs are up from 76.3 miles per hour to 78.8, and changeups are being thrown harder than ever too. Not to mention, pitchers are getting more and more movement than ever before in the new analytical age. Average fastball RPM is 2320, nearly 100 RPM higher than 2015 when it was first tracked. Curveballs have generated almost 250 more RPM, and changeups are up too. It just all goes to show how good pitchers have gotten. Moving the mound back a couple of feet gives batters a little bit extra time to see the ball, which could theoretically increase walks and decrease strikeouts and increase balls in play. However, here's the kicker. Something like this, it would increase movement. Moving the mound back just 2 feet would hypothetically make a baseball thrown at 93.6 right now about 2 miles per hour slower, probably a little less, just around there, which gives more time but also a lot more movement. So this really could have the opposite desired effect.
Back in 2008, when the league average fastball was around 2 miles per hour slower than it is today, the league average OPS was 749, and in 2020 it was 740, in 2019 it was 758. That's with the baseball being thrown about 1.7 miles per hour harder. I really don't think that moving the mound back would create that much of a difference because of the perceived velocity.
That would be so much more increased movement compared to decreased velocity that I think it could really hurt hitters, and the potential for this is why I really don't think it's a good idea if we're trying to fix the issue of balls in play. Final solution, it's one I'm really not a huge fan of because I absolutely love it, but banning pine tar and substances. And I guess technically, pine tar and substances, they are illegal, but to be honest, probably 95% of pitchers in Major League Baseball use this stuff, and MLB just does not enforce it at all. They keep saying they will, and they just simply choose not to. I don't know why, but they don't. It just makes pitchers better. It increases the three true outcomes, and if they truly want to decrease these three true outcomes, this might be the best option available. It really, really might be. They already have the rosin bags on the mound, and that creates better grip. But these substances, they increase spin rate, they increase spin efficiency, they increase velo to an extent, I would say. It allows pitchers to get better grips, throw more accurate. If MLB does choose to enforce these, we could see a huge drop in the three true outcome rate, I think. But
I really don't think MLB is going to, just based on their failure to do so in the past. And then there is one more thing I want to talk about. The pace of play. I really, personally, I don't care. I mean, if I go to a baseball game, I want to be at the ballpark as long as I can. Like, I just want to cherish that moment, I guess. I don't see why MLB is trying to keep the games down so long. I guess maybe to appeal to younger fans, but I really don't think that is a huge problem. I definitely don't think it's a problem at the forefront of baseball right now. Like, there are so many more important problems that they should be focusing on, in my opinion. But yeah, anyways, I do hope you enjoyed. There is probably way more that I did not get into in this video that I may have been able to highlight, but hopefully I didn't. Hopefully I covered a lot. Let me know what you think. Do you think they should do nothing or make some type of change? Personally, if they do, I hope it's lowering the mound a tiny bit or limiting the substances, because like I said, after all, the rosin bag is on the mound for grip. Leave a like, comment. Again, thanks for watching so much. I am happy to be back making videos. And until next time, I am Jason Hayward Stan.